She bared her soul to help victims of domestic violence know when and how to safely leave their abusers. I recently sat down with local author Joanna Hunter, whose book titled But He'll Change was published last month. We chose to pre-record the interview to protect her identity. Joanna, thank you so much for joining us. The byline to this book says, end the thinking that keeps you in an abusive relationship. What is the first step?
The first step is to understand that it's not your fault, and that all these things that you're telling yourself are things that you've been taught, and your partner has impressed on you. And you need to know that what is happening to you is not your fault, and that you are not responsible in any way. It's all about him.
What is the most dangerous excuse or justification that a victim tells him or herself that prevents them from getting there?
I think it could be, but I love him. Mm-hmm. And then they stop there. Well, what do you really love about him? What would you change about him? And is it really him that you love? Or is it this person that he was when he was wooing you into the relationship that you love? Because you certainly aren't loving the person you're living with now.
And you say that even if you feel like you love the person, you have to close off your heart anyway.
Yes, sometimes we have to close our heart to people we love. And we think that we're never ever going to find anyone else. No one else will ever want us. But they will. There will be someone else out there.
What was the last straw for you? What got you over the hurdle?
I think that it was when the abuse started to spill over on my children. That was very difficult when he was getting more angry, and my kids were getting older, so they were staying up later, and they were becoming more involved in the abuse, in hearing the abuse and witnessing it. And that just wasn't okay. It wasn't okay for him to be screaming at them and berating them. That was not okay. And I think for a lot of women, that's about the last straw, when they touch your kids or when they start yelling at your kids.
How many times did it take you to leave? I know the statistic is 7, but did it take you more than once?
No. I left, the first time I left was it, and it was because I was afraid that if I went back, he would kill me.
What is the most important message, knowing there are people out there who might be in an abusive relationship right now, the one thing you would want to say to that person is what?
Is go get help. Either call the national hotline, call DAZE, call your best friend or a friend or your pastor. Call somebody or go see somebody and tell them what's going on, because you need to be surrounded by people who know how to help you leave, and DAZE is an organization that can do that.
Well, Joanna, you are very brave. Thank you for sharing your story and coming on and being willing to talk with us. And we do want to let everyone know that if you would like to purchase a copy of Joanna's book, But He'll Change, we will post information on our web channel, NBC15.com. Just click on News Links. And you can also follow Joanna on Facebook and Twitter. Those links are posted online as well.